to the message tonight.
Thank you, Brother Wayne. I greet you all with the peace of the Lord. A paz do Senhor Jesus a todos.
Peace of the Lord Jesus to everyone that are listening to us and are following us through the app.
A paz do Senhor Jesus,
peace of the Lord Jesus to the ones who are also watching from far away.
We have
been invited to enter into our WhatsApp event. We are going to start by meditating on the word of the Lord in the book of the prophet Isaiah.
Vamos ler apenas
chapter 6,
alguns versos,
Isaiah chapter 6, the seven first verses of Isaiah chapter 6.
Podemos ler até o oitavo.
Can
Isaías, capítulo 6,
read up to the 8th,
do verso primeiro até o oitavo.
Isaiah 6, from verse 1 to the
8.
In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting in a throne, high and lifted up, and the train of his robe filled the temple. Above it stood seraphim. Each one had six wings. With two he covered his face, with two he covered his feet, and with two he flew. And one cried to another and said, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. And the posts of the door were shaken by the voice of him who cried out, and the house was filled with his smoke. So I said, Woe is me, for I am undone, because I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of people of unclean lips. For my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. Then one of the seraphim flew to me, having in his hand a live coal which he had taken with the tongs from the altar. And he touched my mouth with it, and said, Behold, this has touched your lips. Your iniquity is taken away, and your sin purged. Also, I heard the voice of the Lord saying, Whom shall I send, and who will go for us? Then I said, Here am I, send me. Let's close our eyes and pray to the Lord. Lord God, beloved Father, your word has been read, and we know that it's from it that we remove our sustenance. From the simple fact that we read it, we have already received a blessing. And while meditating on the words of life from the Lord, and at this moment, through the message, go visiting each heart, each mind, bringing to our memory what needs to be remembered, speaking to the hearts of the ones who need a blessing. Tonight, we pray so that everything that is said coming straight from your throne of glory, Lord. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. My beloved, tonight, we are reading in the prophet that is called one of the most messianic prophets in the world, Isaiah. He was blessed with prophecies that are related to the return of the Lord Jesus, and God used him powerfully to the coming of the Lord Jesus and to describe the characteristics of his personality and even the physical characteristics of the Lord Jesus in his first coming. In the book of Isaiah, it was written in a large part by him and a small part by others who described the events during the life of Isaiah, and clearly three important points in this book that we need to pay attention for our understanding of what the Lord wants to speak to us in this message tonight. And the first point to be highlighted, Isaiah was appointed, he was called to point out the sin of the people and make them aware of the consequences of sin of which they could be made blamed. And we know that there's a sin that is important, which is the sin of going against the will of the Lord, the direction of the Lord. The people then, they felt self-sufficient and turned their backs to the Lord. And we see this clearly in the way the king Uzziah dies, because King Uzziah was a man that began his kingdom in a well and a blessed way, and to a certain point of his kingdom, he did everything according to the will of the Lord. But there was a moment in his life in which he thought that he didn't need God anymore. He already had power and sovereignty, and his power would be enough for him no longer need the Lord. So when he was, when the prophets before Isaiah came to him and told him and to correct him, there was a spirit of rebellion very great in him, and as a consequence of his sin, he was committed of leprosy. And that brings us to this moment that the Bible describes the verse that we just read. And second point, so that we understand the situation of Isaiah, his role was to proclaim to that people that had sinned and that was suffering the consequences of sin, that there was hope. And the hope was related to the repentance. So there was repentance for the future generation of the exiled, and there was a promise that there was going to be a restoration from captivity. And the third and last point, it's a very important point, in order for us to speak about Isaiah and about the story of Isaiah, one of the most important of all of them was to proclaim the first coming of the Messiah. We are here going through days in which the world is living a moment in which they celebrate only once a year the coming of the birth of the Lord Jesus. And it was Isaiah who mentioned it was a child who came to us, and his kingdom, all the power, all the anointing, all the grace, all the responsibility of bringing life, to bring deliverance, was upon the shoulders of the Lord Jesus. The people that was walking darkness saw a great light, and over the ones who were inhabited on the shadow of death, shines a new light. So there is hope. The proclaiming of the coming of the Lord Jesus, the Messiah, to pointing out the necessity of repentance, this message was in the hands of Isaiah. And he brilliantly describes this child, Jesus, a child that was given to us. He described his kingdom. The responsibility was upon his shoulders. He called him Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Father of Eternity, and Prince of Peace. But see, my brethren, that before Isaiah, being all of this, before he was used in this way, with this great depth, this instrument that we just spoke about, he needed to have a personal experience with the Lord. And his experience with the Lord, it begins exactly in the moment in which King Uzziah dies. Because the way in which Uzziah dies, it shows clearly that he dies in a situation of disobedience and decadence. It was a moment of darkness, spiritual darkness, but the Bible speaks in the text that we read, it says, in the year in which King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting upon a high and sublime throne. And up until then, Isaiah, we could refer to him as someone that knew the Lord, from tradition, from hearing about, from the Jewish tradition, but his deepest experience that he had was a moment in which King Uzziah died. So King Uzziah there, it typifies the old man. When we let go of everything that we think we are, and we begin to look and see that the Lord is sitting upon His throne, speaks about His sovereignty, His omnipresence, being a God that is all-knowing. And only in this way he saw the Lord. And the moment in which he sees God, he sees the temple that was filled with the glory of God. And the Bible says that the presence of the Lord, the glory of the Lord, filled the temple, represented by his garments. They were filling the entire environment where Isaiah was. And we imagine in what moment someone enters into a temple, in the moment of prayer, in the moment of supplication. So Isaiah enters in a moment seeking the Lord, in a moment of anguish. He sees the death of the king and the expectancy of the new king that was about to arrive, and he comes here seeking the Lord, supplication to the Lord. And in this moment of seeking the Lord, he contemplates the glory of the Lord, the ministry of the angels, and an allegoric explanation from the part of the Lord about the reverence, about the fear of the Lord, about the respect towards the things of the Lord. In the moment in which he sees the seraphims, and above the temple, each one had six wings, with two they covered their face, and two they covered their feet, and with two they flew. My brethren, this angelical ministration brings us an example of work, because with two wings they flew, and speaks about the fear of the Lord, with two they covered their faces, and also we speak about reverence, because with two wings they cover their feet, and our walk has to be based on the angelical example that was given in the vision of Isaiah. And in the moment in which he saw this, he observed that they were not silenced, they were not talking with one another, but they were pleading to one another, crying out, saying, "Holy, holy is the Lord of hosts," showing that they knew clearly, they knew each other and the power of the Lord. They recognized and they highlighted and exalted the name of the Lord in the moment in which they were in the temple. And the word of the Lord says that the glory of the Lord was so great in that day, at that moment, that the door posts, they moved with an earthquake. And we see the presence of the Lord shaking that place, causing that place to shake with the voice of the one who called. In the presense of the Lord, the glory of the Lord was seen through the frankincense. It was not only the prayer of Isaiah that was coming to the Lord God, but it was the prayer of all the ones who were remaining, who were faithful, because God always counted on and always will count on the ones who are faithful. And at that moment, Isaiah humiliated himself and said, "Lord, oh Lord, I'm going to perish, because a man of impure lips and inhabit amongst a people of impure lips." And even being in that situation, my eyes have seen the Lord. My eyes have seen the Lord, and because of this, because I saw the Lord of hosts, I'll be destroyed because I'm unworthy. He recognized how small he was before the Lord, and that pleases the Lord. Pleased the Lord so much that immediately he gave an order to one of the seraphims that brought on his hand a live coal from the altar that he brought and touched his lips with that live coal. And soon after, he said, "This touched your lips, and your iniquity has been removed and purified. Your sin was purified." And it was showing that in the moment in which Isaiah recognized how small he was, he humiliates himself and confessed that he is nothing to the Lord, and confessing that if it is not the mercy of the Lord, he would be destroyed. And exactly what we believe. We believe in the mercies of the Lord. They are the cause that we are not destroyed. And immediately, he received favor from the Lord. He moved the resource so that the lips of Isaiah would be touched and would be purified. side.
Agora,
so now,
ele estava pronto.
He was ready.
E ele ouve o Senhor perguntando.
And he heard the Lord asking, who am I going to send?
Como se o Senhor estivesse dando uma oportunidade.
Like the Lord was giving him an opportunity.
Quem há de ir por nós?
Who is, who can go for,
on
our behalf? And he sees there the presence of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The three points that we mentioned, the characteristics of the ministry of Isaiah, pointing out sin, proclaim hope, and proclaim the return of the Messiah, the coming of the Messiah.
And
so then they ask, who am I going to send? And Isaiah, in the midst of humility and boldness, he answers, here I am, Lord, send me. And my brethren,
nós vemos claramente
we can see clearly in this passage
o processo,
the process of salvation and his action and his and its process. Because man, when man dies to the world, dies to the things of this life and of the flesh, man enters into the presence of God with his supplication, with desire of transformation. His sin was pointed out, he recognized his sin, he became aware of his sin, so now he enters into the presence of God, and he hears the proclamation of the hope. There is hope for the ones who sin but have repented. There's a future, there's hope. There's a condition to be restored, the sin to be restored from this captivity, which is what oppresses us. And there is hope in a Savior. The Messiah is one who comes to save, to rescue, to solve. And so we accept Jesus as our only Savior, and the Holy Spirit convinces of our sin, and we repent, we let go of it, and now our hope is to be soon in the glory with the Lord. We begin to experience the means of grace, the subsidy from the glory, the fruit of the Spirit, the spiritual gifts. We begin to experience things that we didn't even know, but now causes us to be amazed. How many people have their testimony of the fact that when they came into the presence of the Lord, they were so amazed because they didn't have much wisdom. They wanted to speak about the details of the revelations in public places and businesses where they entered. This is the first love. The first love is something that fills our lives. In the same way as the cape of the Lord covered that place. Our structures are shaking. The doorposts, they shook. So it's a life that is transformed. So the person begins to enter into a new phase, a phase in which the person says, I'm not worthy. I'm unworthy of so much love. I'm unworthy of so much hope. I'm unworthy of so much promise. And that's exactly what pleases the Lord, when we recognize how small we are, when we recognize that without God, we are nothing, we're worthless. That's when His importance begins to be part of our lives, and when that coal was taken from the altar and placed on our lips, it speaks about transformation, and preparing him to be for his instrumentality. So now he can go, and when man repents of his sins, and he knows that Jesus will return, then man is taken over by an experience. The stamp of the Holy Spirit has come upon him. And that live coal touching on his life, on the lips of Isaiah, speaks exactly about this, of the baptism of the Holy Spirit. It's an experience that is so profound that it puts a seal on him. And nothing will take his blessing, his commitment with the Lord of hosts. And now we see God giving him an opportunity. Who am I going to say, send? And when the servant of the Lord, when the servant of the Lord enters into the presence of the Lord, seemingly the work of the Lord as a project, the man is ready. And the answer is only one, Lord, send me. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And tonight, Lord has given, as we prayed for this service, gave a vision about a woman. She received a pearl as a gift, but in her mind, in her own thoughts, she thought that this pearl was heavy. But even so, she accepted this pearl. And when she received this pearl, she, the expression that came out of her lips was or expressions of joy, of life, and gratitude. She understood that there was no weight at all on that pearl, but she understood that through that gift, the pearl was going to be a gift for her life that was going to bring joy and was going to be the most precious thing that exists for her life. My brother and sister, you who are watching us, maybe there may be very little for you to say like Isaiah, "Here I am, Lord, send me." Maybe you who are watching us, you may be a friend of the church, as someone that sympathizes with the gospel, with the purpose of the Lord Jesus and salvation, but you have not taken the greatest step in your life. But we are introducing to you tonight a Jesus that can change all things, that can turn the old man fall to the ground. He can cause all your actions, the old ones, and of sin that are related to the world, that you may become aware of them, and that you may repent, and that you may enter into a new phase in your life, a new dimension of your spiritual life, so that you may enter and become a part of a people that sees the glory of God, that sees the angels of the Lord, that has fear of the Lord, and sees the acts of justice of the Lord. And this text that we just read speaks of the levity of the gospel. God revealed to Isaiah at that moment that the gospel is something that is light, the presence of the Lord, salvation in Christ Jesus. That was something that he didn't even know. The gospel of Jesus was going to come much later after Isaiah, but he could already realize that serving the Lord was something light, was something that he would have no difficulty in performing, because the Lord was going to do all things. And my brother and sister, you who are watching us tonight, know that in the presence of the Lord, serving the Lord requires only obedience and a heart that is leaning towards following the instruction of the Lord. And everything else, He will do. The Bible says, "Seek out the Lord and all the other things will be added unto you." And we want to speak more clearly about this text, about the prophecy, about the conversation that exists in the eternity between Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. When they see the original sin entering into the world, and the person of the Lord Jesus saying, "Here I am, send me." And He was sent. He came, became man, lived amongst us, and when He was around 30 years, He begins His ministry, and He begins preaching and healing and presenting a new way of life. And when He was around 33 years of age, He gives Himself. And the promise He had made in eternity, that He, when He said, "Here I am, send me," it was fulfilled. He dies, death of cross, in order to save us, so that you and I may come today and experience the frankincense that surround the house of the Lord, and the doorposts that shake when the Lord manifests in our midst, the presence of the angels that when they enter and take our needs, and then they return, like the Bible describes us, with the answers to our prayers, like in the way we sing, the angels bring answers from the Lord. You are invited to live, experience all of this. Open up your heart. So now we're going to sing a song. May this word may have a profound impact in your life, in your mind, in your heart, so that you may comprehend and serve the Lord with wholeness of heart in the genuine gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. May the Lord bless us. Let us sing this song. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
We're going to have
a word of adoration to the Lord at this moment,
for this service, for this moment,
even if virtually we are meeting, renew our fellowship with the Lord and with His Holy Spirit, and the word of the Lord brings life, brings strength, so that we may continue and to be with the Lord soon, eternally.
Lord
God, we praise You, glorify Your name, Lord, because You are holy, You are the one who are in our midst. We praise Your name, Lord, because You are this God, a God that has not allowed anything to be lacking in our lives. We praise You for this blessing of having the Lord as our God. We praise You, Lord, with all our heart tonight for everything that You have done for us. For everything that You ought to do, we praise You with all our heart in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Glória a Jesus.
Glory to Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Nós vamos orar encerrando este culto.
Pray, bring the service to a close. I'd like to remind the brethren that we are available after the end of the service to pray to whomever wants. We can give you a clarification about anything, especially if you have identified with the spiritual gift that was mentioned. We are here making ourselves available to help, to pray with a friendly love that comes from the Lord. Let's pray. Beloved Father, we glorify for the service tonight, for Your presence in our midst, because Your angels are walking amongst us in our homes as we gather here. We know that by faith, You have acted, delivering, healing, and even saving. We can say this by faith, because every day we are Lord in Your presence, and we are taking advantage of the dynamic of the salvation. We praise You for the participation of the brethren, for the zeal that each one has had with Your kingdom, and with the project and purpose of the Lord for our lives. Bless each home, each house here represented, by which brother and sister that connected with us, and the physical and spiritual health of our people, as we prepare for the great meeting with the Lord so that we can live eternally with You. Sustain us, Lord, in every area of our life. Receive our praise and gratitude of our heart for this new moment and this other service in Your presence. In the name of the Lord Jesus, amen.
Amen,
my brethren. The brethren now are free to open up your microphones and greet each other. Manifest if you desire prayer. On next service is going to be tomorrow, 7:30 tonight at night, and during the morning, you brethren follow Sunday school through YouTube. We desire everyone the peace of the Lord Jesus.
Paz do Senhor, rogado. Paz do Senhor, irmãos.
Senhor, meu filho.
Senhor,
irmãos.
Paz do Senhor, a todos.
Paz do Senhor, Lúcia.
Paz do Senhor, amor.
Tá comigo, hein, Gabi?
Paz do Senhor, queridinha. Tudo bem?
Paz do Senhor, tio Davi.
Paz do Senhor, você tá sumido, hein? Parece mais.
Sejam sem mil das coisas.
Paz do Senhor, João.
Ah, Senhor! Ah, Senhor, a todos, a gente está precisando de oração.
Peace of the Lord, my little
friend. Paz do Senhor, meu irmão.
Paz do Senhor.
Ele é isso aí,
Paz do Senhor.
Quanto tempo, né?